Alright, we're all good. Hello everybody, this is Gaming Scott. We're playing Crash Bandicoot. We are going to start a journey. If you're on the stream, you can see the journey. If not, well, if you're on YouTube, you probably have put it in the title. But, this auto-save. This is a journey to 100% and get all the gold relics for Crash 1. Depending on life and how I feel, maybe do it for Crash 2 and 3. I don't know.
Dr. Cortex, we haven't determined the cause of past failures.
Watch the cutscene.
Moron! This bandicoot will be my general. He will lead my Cortex commandos to world domination. This time, I shall reign triumphant. We are closer than ever before. Quickly, into the vortex.
Dr. Cortex, the vortex is not ready. We have no idea what it could do.
Failure again. Capture him!
Uh-oh.
Prepare the female bandicoot.
Oh, those bandicoots always get themselves in those types of troubling situations, you know? You know? Alright, so this... Yeah, we know what's going on. Alright, so this is Sandy Beach, the OG. So yeah, what we're probably gonna do is we're gonna try to do the 100% first, and then afterwards we'll work on getting all the gold relics. Cause that will be probably not the most fun. See if we can get this out of the way first. I tell you, whenever I first picked up the Insane Trilogy, I obviously did Crash 1 first. And, like, for some reason, that took me ages to do. Like, literally ages. Like, I died so much doing that. I don't know why. Just hadn't 3D platformed in a long time, I guess. Alright, we got the gem. Easy peasy. And that's the only level we can get the gem on for... I think until Boulders, the Boulders level. There's the next one we don't need a gem for. I could be wrong, but... Okay, so Jungle Rollers! Alright, let's go! Ba 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 da 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 da. See, I did 100% Crash 2. Cold Hard Crash and Piston It Away are terrible levels. At least for 100%ing. Cold Hard Crash, death. Death level, death bonus is awful. Piston in a way is so much backtracking. It's insane. Aw, I should have got that after. Whoops. I could just have been invincible the whole level. Yeah, here, we need a gem for that. I forget what gem or where, what level you get it from, but I'll figure it out. That's always one of the most scary things to do. I guess we'll do the bonus level. We don't really need to do the bonus level, but why not? It's fun. Now we'll do what we can. Get extra lives. And who doesn't want extra life? We'll need those lives for Roach Nowhere in High Road. Jump that. Yeah, I missed 3 boxes from the gem. But that's okay. If somehow you don't know this by now, you only need to not die to get the colored gems. In the original, you couldn't die for any gems, even the white gems, but they changed it in the remake, so you can you can get just the regular white gems without, you can die and still get the white gems. It's just the colored gems that you're not allowed to die. Which is a nice compromise, but then, Slippery Climb has a colored gem, and then you're just like, well, whatever. Again, we can't get the white gem for this level. I forget if this is a level that has the gem at the very end of the level. You have to like bypass the exit. Yeah, I know it's one of the gate levels, I believe. I'm not sure if it's this one. Oh well. Invincibility rules! Yeah, screw you, bud. Don't want to die while being invincible. That will be embarrassing. Probably should have been a little bit more patient at the end, because don't want to, like, be touching one of those spikes while I lose my invincibility. But it's cool. Okay. Extra lives. Let's go. We'll have 99 lives in no time. Oh, okay. So yeah, the gem is at the end of the level. Yeah, it kind of goes over to the other side, I guess. doing a lot better now that I've played Crash a bunch. Like, I'll tell you, whenever I first played this, I did awful. Like, I died so much. It was terrible. Alright, boulders, I believe we can get the gem on this one. We don't need anything. So, we'll try to do that. There's only 16 boxes. And we can die. So that's good news. Easy peasy. Y'all play Crash this remake. Do you do the D-pad or do you use analog sticks? Honestly, I find I can't do it with analog sticks. I've tried and it's just too weird. Don't know why that one platform is yellow and it drops. Like, you're not really gonna have any time to stand there long enough to die by it dropping anyway. Maybe just if you're paying attention that much, you can know for later levels that if it has a yellow ring around it, it drops. But at the time, the color of the platforms you're jumping on is probably not the thing you're most paying attention to. Right, upstream, good stuff. Need a gem for to get the gem. Ba 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 da 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 da. When did I die? I died? When have I had a level 2 Aku Aku mask? I don't remember dying. When did it ever go away? Alright, well, that's understandable, I suppose. Also, fun fact, you can spin these fish away. If you didn't know. Soundtrack for this level and these levels in general is just so cool. This was a fun level to gold relic. I think I got a gold relic. Oh, that was close. I think I got a gold relic for this level. I was on my other save file, I was relicking a few levels, and this was one of them. I think I got gold. Or maybe. No, I think I got platinum on one of the levels. I forget which one. I don't mean one of these upstream theme levels. I just mean a level. But I forget which one. Nice! gem here. Is Ripper next? Oh, Papu. Ripper is the second boss. So we're doing good. We're doing good stuff. But I'll tell you, I sucked. When I first bought this game and was playing it, I was like, I couldn't even kill Papu because I was trying to spin on his head. Yeah, that's Papu. We already got one boss down. Easiest boss. Rolling Stones. I remember some of these levels. The first time I played them in Rolling Stones, I thought it was another boulder level. Because, you know, Rolling Stones, it sounded like it would be. But it's not. It's another jungle level with the spinning wheels. Is it maybe this level I platinum? I was only relicking the short levels, like Sunset Vista, Slippery Climb. I didn't try touching those, but I will for this. Oh shoot! No! I messed up. Yeah, see, there's an embryo tower. Oh, well, we're not gonna 100% this level, I don't think. Yeah, we need a gem for this anyway, so it doesn't matter. I was sad for a second, but I thought about it. I was like, eh. We're not gonna get the white gem either way. Ah! So easy. This little bridge of crates, but like I said in the first level, where the invisible block bridge happened, I just had such a hard time with it. The very first time I played the game. It's like, oh my goodness, is my 3D platforming skills that bad now? But as you can hopefully tell, in this new playthrough, they've improved since then. Sorry, Enfrio. Where's your second one? I missed your second one. It was probably somewhere, I guess. Obviously, it was somewhere. The second Brio token was somewhere. Yeah. Okay. before Crash. So many boxes. So many boxes. So yeah, no, I'm gonna export these to YouTube someday. I don't know how long we're gonna make the video. It's maybe 15-20 minutes. It seems good. The levels are quick, at least to start off. Going through a lot of levels. Hog Wild, I believe we can get the gem for. There's no, yeah, it would be hard to have an alternate path that you need a gem for. Checkpoint. Another checkpoint. Okay, we did it. Oh, this one. All right, did that easy peasy. Jump. Stay down, and then the third hog is awful. Oh! No! Oh, I would have cried. One try, baby! Ba-da-ba. I see, like, if I looked on the relic screen, and, like, I don't know how you can get, like, different times. Like, how do you time trial this level? Like, how do you... The hog is a given speed. So I'm not sure how you can go faster. I don't think. Like, I know.